Hello, my name is Mike. In this first of our three-part series on OTBI functionality, we'll be looking at creating and saving an advanced report. I'm going to create a new analysis in the worker assignment real-time subject area. I'll use the browser search to quickly find the subject area I'm looking for. I'll start by searching for worker assignment. Then I'll search on person date, which will give me a few options to choose from. And finally, assignment count. I've added some criteria, but the results at this point aren't particularly useful, so now I'm going to edit the formula to calculate the age of the person. I'm looking for the difference between two dates. Before I add this function, I can see the syntax and an explanation. I want to change the interval to year. Then I'll change this part of the formula to current date. Before I save this, I'll also change the column heading. Now I can see the current work assignments by age, but I'd really like to see this by age bands. For my first age band, I want to see everyone under 25. I'll enter 0 to 25 as my first band name, and OTBI will sort these bands alphabetically. The 0 at the front of the name means this will appear first. I can add as many bins as needed, but right now I only need 4. Now I'll add my last one. Then I'll edit this bin name for those who haven't entered any date of birth at all. Now that I'm looking at the information by age bands, I want to change my column heading. Now I've got something that looks more like a usable report. The age bands appear in blue, which means I can click on them for more information. However, for this report, I don't want to allow that, so I'm going to remove that ability. Now I have the report that I want. I want to use age bands in other reports, so I'll save it so I can reuse it. Since age band is based on the common worker dimension, I want to save it to a common folder that's not related to a subject area. Once it's saved, I can drag it into any report where I want to use it, as long as the worker dimension appears in one of the subject areas in the report. The last thing I want to do is save the report. Now that the report is saved, it can be used as needed. This concludes the Creating an Advanced Report tutorial, part 1 of our 3-part series on OTBI functionality. Thanks for watching.